libation?
A little. Just a little.
For those of you who do not know who I am, my name is Donna Gray Banks. I am the director and founder of the F.R.E.S.H. Festival. And we've had 5 workshops this year in the city of Daytona. And we are very grateful to be a part of this magnificent building. We have not been through it. You have to look at it. It is a complete music studio. It has a full-size gym. It has an enormous dance studio. And it's just really a pearl in the middle of the city.
Yes.
And so we're really happy to have it. Mm-hmm. And thank you for coming to our last workshop this season. Mm-hmm. They will resume again in April. For those of you who don't know, the F.R.E.S.H. Festival is the 8th and 9th of January in this facility. Friday night is the meet and greet, and that's where all, because you work so hard on Saturday, you gotta have a meet and greet on Friday.
Mm-hmm.
And we have music and jazz and food, and all the authors get to meet each other, and on Saturday we go to work. And so I hope you all are able to make it. And this evening, what a day it's been.
Yes, Lord.
Yes.
So, I honor you all for taking the time because we all have very busy schedules.
Mm-hmm.
And so, being here tonight, I'm very humbled by this presence. And my friends from Palm Coast, thank you so much. I haven't seen them in many years. Her baby boy. I said, how's your baby boy? She's 17.
Yes. baby.
So my friend, Charlene Thomas, came such a long way. Thank you. She's an editor and an author, has her own publishing company, and she's going to tell you more about herself. And she's coming on to speak. My good friend, Evelyn Bethune, is a publisher. The best road dog in town. publisher, author, entrepreneur. She has the skill set to do just about everything. So she's been very blessed with a lot of gifts. Angie BEE is a producer. She's a writer. She's an audio guru.
Mm-hmm.
And she's married to a gentleman I've known for years. We are very glad to have you both and everybody.
The dude. She's like a legend. When I lived and worked in Orlando, my boss owned a radio station. So I'd be hanging out in the radio station with him, and he'd talk about his family and how famous his aunt was and how she ran this little city, and she was just all that. And so finally I said, what is your aunt's name and where does she live? You know, and she lives in Daytona Beach, and her name is Evelyn Bethune. And I said, is she the mayor? And he said, no, she's baby. And so when I met Barty and I went to work one day and told my boss, you know, I think I'm going to be moving to Daytona. He was like, good, I need you to meet my aunt because she runs Daytona. So thank you for allowing me to meet you tonight. Donna, thank you for feeding us because the libations. I'm looking forward to it. Anyway, my name is Angie BEE and Barty is my husband. And I have lived here in Daytona Beach for about 2.5 years. We were married in 2013, and it has been a joy being in Daytona. I tell you, born and raised in Detroit, mm-hmm. and couldn't wait to get out, and went to a black college in Dayton, Ohio, mm-hmm. and, you know, all the pledging and everything took place in the cornfield, and I couldn't wait to get out of there. And got to Orlando, and was like, okay, this is cool. That was before the Orlando Magic came, so Orlando was a small little place. Mm-hmm. You know everybody, and then it started turning into what it is now. Mm-hmm.
So I praise God for how he has ordered my footsteps.
Mm-hmm.
And that is the beautiful thing about my book and my business. Because I didn't want to write this book,
mm-hmm.
and I didn't want to start that business.
Mm-hmm.
I was quite really crazy about marrying that man that just loved that job. The Lord has ordered my footsteps, and I'm happy with all of it. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
So the name of my book is Last Week I Wanted to Die.
And I literally wrote it under duress because God kicked me out of the bed and said, go type. And I went to the computer and he had me to write the story of my third suicide attempt. Mm-hmm. And how my daughters were affected by it, by my then, now ex-abusive husband was a part of it, how my church was not supportive of the mental illness, how I found out that the mental illness ran in my family mm-hmm. when I thought I was the only one going through it. Mm-hmm. And it's not just another book about depression and attempted suicide, but it's a personal reflection and an honest interpretation of my battle with an inherited mental illness. I remember taking this picture, actually my daughter taking a picture, and she said, Mom, you need to have a photo shoot. And I was like, for what? And we literally went outside with the only dress that I could wear at the time. I weighed 357 pounds mm-hmm. and could not stand before anyone because the type 2 diabetes and the neuropathic nerve pain in my feet, however you say it. You can't stand. So my photo shoot, I sat right there. And I remember thinking, God, what am I supposed to do? I can't get out of bed. Mm-hmm. I got kids to raise. I can't function. I can't. And that was the picture that she took. I was just really reflecting on God and what I was supposed to do next. And this became the cover of the book. The book is published by True Soul Publishing. Again, God ordered my footsteps because I didn't know this woman from Adam, didn't know nothing about publishing. And her motto is that her publishing company is an umbrella for survivors. Mm-hmm. And I survived the third suicide attempt. Mm-hmm. Praise God. And she was wonderful enough to say, just send me what you typed. Thank you, Ms. Evelyn. Just send it to me. Let me see how it flows. I was like, okay. Into a Microsoft Word document. She said, okay, we're going to format it. Do you have any pictures? I was like, well, yeah, I got some family pictures around here somewhere. Well, scan them and send them to me. I mean, she just held my hand through the process. And that's something that I love about publishing companies. Because mm-hmm. they know what they're doing. What is this barcode on the back? I don't know what that's for. Publishing companies know what that is. Registering in the Library of Congress, someplace in Washington. Mm-hmm. I don't know nothing about that. Mm-hmm. A publishing company does, mm-hmm. and I'm grateful for that. She was able to say, well, you need a couple of commas here, and a couple of semicolons, and a couple of things that I know I learned in school somewhere, but I forgot. So I'm not going to say that writing a book for you is as easy as it was for me, because I just wrote what God told me to write. Mm-hmm. But going back over and promoting your book, just mm-hmm. like Ms. Evelyn said, that has been the struggle for me. Mm-hmm. I wrote this book in May of 2011. Mm-hmm. In February 2011, I had had gastric bypass surgery, so I was in the process of a transition. God was making my temple appropriate for him to do mm-hmm. his work through. So mm-hmm. I was losing the weight and getting healthier. The ankles were going down and the type 2 diabetes was going away. But going back over to read the book, mm-hmm. I kept finding, why did I write that? Why did I put that? Why? And I think that's why we become authors multiple times. Mm-hmm. Because the first time, we just getting it out. Then we want to get different versions of it out. The next book is ready to come out. Mm-hmm. And I'm looking forward to Charlene's fifth book. When mm-hmm. I grow up, I'm going to be just like her. She's got four books and running, already, you know. Yeah. Some of you are sitting here thinking, how am I going to get the first one out? Mm-hmm. And so I'm not going to say the first one is as easy as the third and fourth, but once you get it mm-hmm. out, mm-hmm. it's just, okay, thank you, God. Thank you. And so that's been a beautiful thing. So along my journey of promoting the book, just like Ms. Evelyn said, mm-hmm. you got to get somebody in your circle to read the book. Mm-hmm. I was telling my good friend Larissa that mm-hmm. Initially people would buy the book, and I'd follow up with them and say, well, what did you think? Oh, I haven't had a chance to read it yet. That's in my purse. I got it. It's down in the somewhere. Mm-hmm. Where did I put it? Oh, yeah, you signed it for me. Did you give it back to me? Okay. So then I started asking people, well, what would make it easier for you to read it? Because it's only, you know, 30 pages at the bottom. Not an encyclopedia, the M brain. And they said, well, you know, can you just read it to me? I'm like, I'm going to sit here on the phone and read you my book. But for about 7 years prior to writing the book, I did a syndicated radio show. Mm-hmm. It's a holy hip-hop radio show, and it was straight streamed on the internet. Got more listeners in Africa and Australia and London than I had in Orlando.
Right.
But from 4 to 8 p.m. Monday through Friday, I was on the air playing Christian rap music and cracking jokes and telling scripture and trying to say what the pastor said and, you know, translate it to some hip-hop folks.
Right.
And so I said, well, if I could do the radio show, I could do my book on a CD.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what I did. As much as I hated reading this book, I sat down and I read it to myself.
Yeah.
And made a CD.
Mm-hmm.
And then when people came up to me and said, I'm going through depression, or my daughter is cutting herself, or I really gotta, you know, but I don't have $10. Then I could say, well, this only cost me $2 to produce. I could give a bit.
Mm-hmm.
And that made a difference, because that made the word of God alive for someone to read and for someone to listen to. Then I could hear my book, because then it wasn't, I don't know, it's something about black and white that makes it like real. Like when you read the Bible, it's real.
Mm-hmm.
But when you listen to scriptures on tape, it's like, well, yeah, okay, I got it. It can kind of simmer in a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And that helped me learn to promote my book even more. And that's where, again, God ordered my footsteps to where the business grew. NGB Productions only did the radio show. About 4 years ago, we started a tour, and we go around year-round. We bring holy hip-hop concerts to churches and communities, and we do a concert on Friday night. Saturday morning, the gang of us come in, and the moms are over there crying and boo-hooing over something, domestic violence related or something. The dads are in the man cave talking about, my son ain't got ADHD, ain't nothing wrong with my teen, you know. The teenagers are trying to deal with, why do they have to learn math other than the calculator, you know? And so we break off into workshops and we minister to them, and the business kept growing, and more kids kept coming and saying, well, Miss Angie, I got a CD player, but, you know, I've got a video game with a DVD option. Can you just read me your book?
Okay.
I'm like, I'm not going to sit here in front of a camera and And so that's what I did. Over on my laptop, it's just me, sitting in the corner, reading my book to the camera. Well, I cheated. Yeah, let's see.
Would you mind just playing us a few snippets of it? We'd just like to hear your voice.
And I cheated just a little bit, because my husband was behind the camera, so it felt more like I was reading it to him. But it made a big difference, because when I thought about it, when Joyce Meyer is on in my home, I'm still running around doing dishes, I'm making up the bed, I'm not really watching, I'm just observing, but she's there on the screen. And when I realized how many scriptures are contained in my book, and how much wisdom there is that didn't come from me, came from somebody else, it made a real big difference. And that's how God has ordered the footsteps of Angie BEE Productions. Now we're able to work with folks.
Take you to record this?
Well, let me see. We have to ask Bertie, because he was behind the camera. I think it maybe took us, tell me, 15?
I would say about a half an hour.
About a half an hour.
For me to read through the book.
Mm-hmm.
And that's just me reading straight through. We didn't stop
because
we were supposed to be doing something else. We were at a workshop, and I was waiting for folks to show up. And I said, well, come on, at least let me get a couple of chapters done. And the Lord set it up for us to finish it. But again, it allows the word to get from here to paper to somebody's ear with a CD to visually somebody can see it. This may cost me 50 cents to produce. I don't mind giving it to a kid. This may cost $1 to produce. I don't mind giving it to a pastor to show at a woman's conference. Mm-hmm. Now, NGB Productions has grown to where we bring authors with us on the tour. Mm-hmm. Because each author has their own testimony to share, either in the mom's workshop or the dad's workshop or with the teens. And we're gone year-round. My pastor don't ever know when I'm coming to church because we're gone about 3 weekends. We're at Lakeside Village Apartments tomorrow doing the mom's workshop with my friend Naretha and Charlene. And we have authors that come with us, and that's the way to get a new circle of people.
Yeah.
We want to work with publishers that have 9 authors. They got their book out. Can we sit down with them in front of the camera, those 90-year-olds? I get the audio, but man, I'd love to see them on video. You know, sometimes the History Channel will do something from World War II or the 20s or something, and you'll hear the crickly sound of their old, but man, I'm visual. I want
to
put
a face to them.
Yeah. And then the beauty of it nowadays is we can sit with you on camera, and then I can just take the soundtrack from the video, and so you've got both. You've got the video and the... So we want to work with publishers. Mm-hmm. We want to work with people that sit and say, I don't know how to structure a sentence, much less how to get my book started. Okay, well, can we just sit down and you just talk to the camera?
Mm-hmm.
Can you just talk to Barty? Can you just talk to me? Can you just talk to us? I've got someone with AGB Productions that was a court reporter.
Mm-hmm.
Left the system because she got tired of the horrors of the court system and having to document what they did to them. But she can take the audio and type it up. And so there's your book, just like what you're doing with them.
Absolutely.
So let's get it out. What do they say about when you pass a cemetery, it's just full of books and stories that were never written? Let's put Daytona Beach on the map for something more than what we've been... Let's just get it out, because it's no fair. God planted it in you. He ordered your footsteps to be at this place at this time, and then you go home and you're like, well, I guess I better get a notebook. I guess I better claim that I'm an author. I guess I better.
Mm-hmm.
We don't have to do that. So in the meantime, the radio show that I had, that I still have, I love holy hip hop music. I truly do. I'm a youth evangelist, so God has charged me to bring youth to Christ, and I'm honored by that. But once we get them to Christ, their parents are still messed up.
Right.
We still send home the messed up family. Mm-hmm. And so after I realized that the Lord was allowing me to lose weight, so I didn't look like this anymore, and I didn't have to stand in pain anymore. The same network that gave me the radio show said, HB, we want you to do a TV show. Film everything you do. We'll give you a spot once a week on the network. So on the Faith Internet TV network, anytime I can put some lipstick on, it looks like Miss Don. And we can put it to camera. These messages get to go out on the internet. We're able to now interview other people. Sir, you're here because why? Your story may inspire somebody.
Mm-hmm.
Ma'am, why are you here? Mm-hmm. I mean, these stories are so important to our next generation.
Absolutely.
Because kids today figure, well, I don't even have to graduate high school. I can just go get a job.
Mm-hmm.
And then those jobs are miserable. They're not satisfied with them. And then stuff, crap is happening.
Mm-hmm.
So if we're going to minister to the young people in our area, if we're going to help bring some grown folks to Christ, if we're going to get some books and some CDs and some DVDs out, we have to work together.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's what NGB Productions does. If you'd like more information about the tour, we got a whole scrapbook over here of all the places we've gone in the past 4 years. Lord have mercy, I just can't believe how many places we've gone.
Mm-hmm.
We have the audio book version now. We've got you can come be on the tour with us and introduce your book, just like the honorable now retired Judge Grimes has done. And we also have a segment called Video News. It's a 2 to 4 minute segment where I will read to the camera, just like I'm a news reporter, I'll read your press release about your book.
Mm-hmm.
I'll interview you about your book. Mm-hmm. I'll help to promote you just on that video news segment. Because my idol Evelyn Bethune is right. Get it out. And if the folks around you ain't buying it, you need a new circle. Let's give you another circle. So, Ms. Evelyn, I pray that we get a chance to work together. I ask you all to pray over the book. We're entering the season where attempted suicide and depression is at its highest, and not necessarily because of chemical imbalances. So I ask you to pray for people that are struggling. Pray for our young people. I was born in 65. We didn't know nothing about cutting ourselves. But kids today are, what is that?
I don't know.
And so just please pray for them. Invite us to come out with the tour. Yes, my husband will come out and do a Motown review for you. But I'm just honored to be in Daytona. And thank you for allowing us to be here. Thank you.
On video, what would I do to make that happen with you?
You call me?
No, I'm just saying.
Okay. We'll find a comfortable place. Like my buddy Charlene has a TV show, Testimonies of Triumph, I tell you. And she gets to talk to people that have overcome something. And our very first episode that we shot, we just went out on the beach and sat in our swimsuits with the sunscreen on and talked. And that's the beauty of an audio book. If you want to sit and read your book to the camera, you know it better than anybody else does. So you know what emphasis to put into it, and you're looking at things. If I read it, I'm going to be excited because I'm presenting it for you. But if you want to do your audiobook, we'll find a comfortable place where you and I can sit. I'm working with a lady right now who's in Michigan. So we're doing Skype together, and I'm just kind of talking to her and interviewing her, and then she'll read a little bit, and I interview her because she wants to get like a documentary and promotional video ready so that when the book is ready, she'll have something to promote it. And so we find a place that's comfortable for you. And depending upon how large your book is, it may take one or two settings. This took one setting. I sat down, I read it, it was done. But this gentleman got a book that's, 400 pages, you said? We might have to break it up over some of the Saturday. But that's okay, too. But we try to make it very comfortable for you. And when you're done, we'll take the audio and put it on the CD for you. Well, actually, it's an MP3. Because kids today got them things that go in their ears. They don't need CDs. They got them little, you know. So we give you that. And that's available on Amazon, I think. Yeah. So we give you that. And then you can decide if you know how you want your cover to look, what kind of cases you want. My sister Charlene helps a lot with that in terms of how you want your packaging to be. We work together really well with that. If there's something that you want to talk, like you want your audiobook, and then we want to transcribe it to text, Charlene can edit it for you and get it ready. So, like you said, it's enough to go around, but we are working together.
You talked a lot about God ordering your footsteps. Can you give us some examples of maybe some synchronistic things that happen?
Hallelujah. Well, I can give you a couple of, I don't want to go over my time. You know, I preach a little bit, so you got to tell us pretty good to that. But I give you a perfectly good example. I know a man that was not going to go into no church. He loved the Lord with all his heart, but he don't need to go in church. All he wanted is money, so why did he have to go in? He's working hard to make his own money. He was driving down the street to go somewhere else and pass the church. Mm-hmm. And the church said Angie BEE's tour was coming to town, and it was a holy hip-hop concert. Mm-hmm. So he knew his nephew was a Christian rapper, so he parked the car, went in the church, did not get hit by lightning, got the flyer, told his nephew to call the lady. The nephew became a part of the tour for a couple concerts. So he came out to see what his nephew was doing, and why wasn't this lady paying him for rapping? I mean, you get paid to do stuff, right? So he came out, and there was this woman just bouncing around, just hugging, kissing, and loving on everybody, including him. He's like, who is this woman? And why is she all over me? Well, maybe she might want to go to lunch with me. Maybe she might want to date me. Maybe she might want to marry me. So the Lord ordered my husband's footsteps to come to Orlando to see our concert. He ordered our footsteps to come to Daytona.
recording his footsteps. Now, Charlene will testify because she was with the tour longer than my husband was in my life. So, Charlene will talk about how, as focused as I was on doing the work of the Lord, I wasn't building my business. I wasn't promoting my book. Soon as I met my husband, I started looking at, okay, I have a mental illness. How do I date? How do I tell him? I might be crazy today. I might fall out tomorrow. How do you do that when you're trying to be attractive to a man? You don't want to scare him away. So God ordered my footsteps by saying, you need to submit to this man. And restoration and reconciliation will occur. Well, during the time I was meeting him, I was estranged from my eldest daughter. She got so tired of me attempting suicide and being with an abuser that she left at age 17 and hadn't spoken to me since, was just gone. But there was something about him that she liked. So now she calls me every day when the Bengals are winning or losing. Whatever Monday Night Football is going on. We're going to see Star Wars together in December. That was how the Lord ordered my footsteps for restoration. Reconciliation was that I had to learn to forgive my children's father for leaving us, and I had to learn to forgive my second husband for abusing us, and I had to learn to submit to a man. Why the hell do I want to submit to a man? They ain't no good. They just, wow. I had to learn to forgive and love them and pray for them, and then God ordered our footsteps together. As soon as this man was in my life, I was like, okay, well, maybe I'll do the CD, and maybe the DVD, and maybe the mom's workshop needs a corresponding dad's workshop. Maybe we now need to mentor to these teens that are cutting themselves. I'm 50 years old. I don't know nothing about that.
Right.
Lord brought in a 22-year-old that was a former cutter.
Yeah.
Now she ministers to them. And when she ain't there, my husband comes in and says, okay, fellas, y'all got to sit up straight. Look people in the eye when they're talking to you. Move your hand away from your mouth so they can hear you speak. Sit up straight. Be a man.
Pull your pants up.
Pull your pants up. Sorry, keep me on time, you know? And so when God orders your footsteps, you fall in love with somebody who's not your type. I don't look like Halle Berry, and that's what Bartie wanted. Bartie will tell anybody he's been in church more now than he has been probably his whole life because he wants to be there because we're going there together. We do these things together. God will show you what to do even when it's the wrong way to go. When I first learned about Evelyn Bethune, I had no idea I was going to be living in Daytona. Her nephew Jarvis just kept talking about how great Daytona was and how his auntie was running the city.
Exactly.
No idea. No idea. So if you allow the Lord to order your footsteps, if you submit to him, read his word. Even if his word is in a book about a suicidal mother, I got no scripture in here that I don't know where these scriptures came from. Again, you allow him to order your footsteps and you can achieve things that you never would have thought. And what does the scripture say? He'll take your gifts and talents and make a way for you that will bring you joy to what you're doing so you're not miserable at what you're doing. So I thank you. Keep listening to 106.3 as Jarvis is ready. Keep listening. And thank you very much.
Thank you.
And 9th of January.
Right.
And don't think you saw talent here.
We did see talent
here. You can't imagine what you're going to see in January.
Wow.
So we thank you all for coming. Please take a plate with you.
Oh, okay.
Thank you. Thank you for coming.
Yes.